Good morning. Welcome to Little Cypress Baptist Church. We are going to change things up. And so for all of you that are standing around talking right now, you can keep doing that because I want everybody to stand up. And we are going to, Miss Betty's going to play a musical piece for us. And so we're going to use this time to welcome the people that are around here. This is going to be our new fellowship time. And so work your way around, hit Miss Betty a little bit. My name is going to come on and get us started. Once again, welcome to Little Cypress Baptist Church. I just want to highlight a few things in this beautiful information pamphlet production, whatever you want to call it. Cypress Park, if you didn't grab one of those when you came in, make sure before you head out that you grab one of those. So many different things that you'll need to know about, that you'll want to know about. So I just want to highlight a few things that are in there. Inside, you will notice that first and foremost, we have a guest speaker today. And so we're really excited about what's going to happen today. And we also have a guest worship leader. So let's just make sure we're paying attention and we're focused on our Lord most importantly today. But also inside, you will notice there's a write-up about the marriage retreat. We were going to hold our, as far as I know, the first marriage retreat, at least in the last 3.5 years, here at Little Cypress Baptist Church. And there are registration packets back on that big shelf back there for that. We have space, if I remember correctly, for 7 more couples. And so if you are interested in that, make sure you grab one of those. Get registered before the deadline. The deadline to sign up for that is December the 11th. It's going to be a great weekend, great opportunity for you to try maybe to reestablish some communication lines with your spouse, or just get away and grow in your marriage. I think we all can see that there needs to be improvement in each and every one of our marriages, no matter how long you've been married or how short you've been married. So we want to make marriage a priority here at the Little Cypress Baptist Church, and so that's one of the ways that we want to do that. You'll also notice, and this is really for our students, but it's not just for our students, see you at the pole is this week. This is one of the big weeks in student ministry, And so it's an opportunity for our students to go to their school and to spend time in prayer for their nation, for their school, for their family, and for their friends. And so we want to challenge our church to be in prayer for our students as they take that stand to go to the flagpole. And then also in there, you'll see that we are in desperate need of some nursery workers. And so if you would be interested in doing that, you can see the ladies in the office, and they will get you an application for that process. And then also you'll see the meal tear out. If you're interested in eating with us Wednesday night, make sure you fill that out, tear it out, put it in the offering plate when it comes by later this morning. And last, but definitely not least, in the seat backs in front of you are the black folders that also have the prayer request cards. We want to know that you are here. And if you have a specific prayer request that someone can pray for during our service, you can fill that out and then try to get that to Mike Day. He's sitting back there in the back waving his hand. Nice looking guy with a little shiny head. It's really impressive. And so make sure you get that to him at some point during the message this morning so that we can pray for you. So once again, welcome. And I'm going to turn it over to David.
Okay, so we've already had our fellowship song, all of that done, we've had our welcome, we've had our announcements, and now we're going to begin worship. And so I want you to have the opportunity to meet Nikki Hansen. Were you here on Disciple Now Weekend? Any of you remember Disciple Now Weekend? You remember the preacher that Sunday morning? Nikki's husband. All right, now, this gentleman right here with the water bottle, Stan, Nikki's son. And so, Nikki's going to lead worship this morning and this evening, and then we're going to see how much more God will let her do that for us while we're trying to get a search committee together and all of those things that we have to do. Thank you so much.
Great to be here. I'm so excited. I've already seen faces I know, and it's funny because I look at you and you're talking to me, you're being so sweet, and I'll say, I know you. And then you look at me and go, how do I know you? And it's been great putting those pieces together. Let's stand this morning, join our voices together as we worship our Lord. Yeah.
We thank you for loving us so much that you sent your son, Jesus. For those of us who have responded to your call to salvation, today we want to thank you that that was just the beginning of a wonderful life that you are giving us as you are making us more and more like your son. Lord God, there are people here today who may not yet have responded to that call. They may not be aware of the fact that, the life of Jesus was a life of perfection. His death on the cross was a death for all of our sins. His resurrection was a display of the fact that you were pleased with what he had done and that he is Lord over life and Lord over death. Today we pray, Lord, that you would allow that person to understand your great love for them. And regardless of the things that have happened in their past, they would come to you and ask for forgiveness of sins, ask you, Lord Jesus, to save them and to make them a child of God, knowing that when they ask sincerely, that you always keep your word and do what you said to do. We pray, Lord, today for those of us who may be struggling, whatever the situation, whether it's tiredness, whether we're dealing with anxieties,